What's up, everybody? I'm Salem Wasteland, and welcome to UTAU 101. This series is designed as a short online course meant to introduce new users to the singing synthesis software UTAU. In this video, we'll be going over what UTAU is, what it can do, and how to install it. Let's get started. UTAU is a speech synthesis software, which is a bit of a tongue twister, but all that means is that it's a software designed to emulate human speech, in this case, singing. Speech synthesizers come in two main varieties: those that are completely artificial, and those which sample audio recorded from real vocalists. UTAU is the latter. Unlike other major singing synths like Vocaloid, CVO, and Synthesizer V, UTAU is not only completely free, but allows you to input your own voice into the software. A few competitors have shown up over the years, like Niao Niao and more recently Deep Vocal, but so far none have been able to match the quality and flexibility that UTAU provides. UTAU was developed by Amaya in 2008 and was last updated in 2013. The creator continues developing tools that will work with the software, but at time of recording, there's no news of a major update happening anytime soon. Meanwhile, the number of voice banks out there has grown and grown over the years and doesn't show any sign of stopping. Part of the appeal is that the voices are often represented by original characters, which adds another layer to the creative process of developing them. If you're watching this video, there's a good chance you've at least heard of Taro Kasane, who is one of the first UTAU and continues to be one of the most prolific. Basically, UTAU lets you input audio of your voice, make a fun character to go along with it, and have it sing basically whatever you want. That's not to say that your UTAU has to be voiced and designed by you, but you need to have permission for any asset you use for it, be it audio or visual. Sampling audio without consent, such as from celebrities, voice actors, YouTubers, or other vocal synths, is explicitly against UTAU's terms of use. Doing this could create potential legal trouble for both you and for the developer, so don't do it. Similarly, using artwork for your voice bank that was not made by or for you is at best disrespectful to the artist and at worst a violation of copyright. This includes tracing over another artist's work, even if you change the details of the character. I'm not trying to scare anybody off here, these are just important things to know before making and distributing voice banks. As long as your UTAU is 100% yours, you don't have anything to worry about. You can use audio and artwork provided by other people as long as they've given you permission. With all that out of the way, let's go over what UTAU can and can't do. Using UTAU, you can create libraries of audio files called voice banks, share your voice banks online and download ones created by other people, create covers of songs you like, create vocal tracks for original music, design original characters to represent your voice banks, use different flags and resamplers to manipulate their sound, use and create plugins to expand the capabilities of the software, and interact with a huge diverse community of creators from all around the world. Most of the limitations arise from small things in the interface, the fact that the software is over 10 years old, and the fact that you have to do a lot of things manually if you want the best result. It's due to this manual nature that UTAU has been able to be pushed as far as it has, but that also creates a pretty steep learning curve and the potential for a huge time sink. It's really easy to get lost and frustrated when you're just starting out, but that's what these videos are here to help with. Now let's move on to installing the software. We're going to be installing the English version of UTAU onto Windows 10. The first thing we want to do is set our system locale to Japanese. If you don't do this, UTAU won't be able to read or display Japanese characters properly, and you'll run into a lot of problems when trying to use it. You'll need to be on an account with administrator privileges, and you'll need to restart your PC afterwards, so be prepared for that. To change your locale, open the Start menu, type in Control Panel, and find the application of that name. From here, navigate to Clock and Region, then Region. This will open up a small window. While we have this open, we can also quickly check our decimal settings. Click on the button at the bottom of the window that says Additional Settings, and in the new window that pops up, make sure that the box next to Decimal Setting has a period in it. If it doesn't, select the period from the drop-down menu and click OK. Back in the region window, click on the second tab labeled Administrative, and then the button that says Change System Locale. Select Japanese Japan from the drop-down menu and accept the prompt to restart your computer. Doing this shouldn't change your language or region settings, but it may make some older softwares try to install in Japanese by default. Chances are, you won't run into any problems. Now we're ready to download and install UTAU. Go to the website utau2008.xrea.jp, linked in the description. Click on the first link under Download labeled V0.4.18e Instora. The E in this version indicates that it has the improved English interface. Save the zip file wherever you want, extract the executable installer, and run it. The installer is in Japanese, but there aren't that many things that you'll need to customize in it. The buttons at the bottom of the screen read Cancel, Back, and Next. Hit Next once to go to the second page of the installer. By default, UTAU will try to install in your program files, but it may be beneficial to install it somewhere else, like your documents folder or on your desktop, due to later versions of Windows having more restrictions on the default permissions of this folder. You can choose where to install it by clicking the button next to the path name labeled R for reference. I installed mine to the desktop of this computer. The option at the bottom of the screen is asking whether or not you want to install for all users E or only for the current user M. Once these settings are how you want them, hit Next to go to the next screen, then Next again, and wait for UTAU to install. This shouldn't take more than a few minutes. When the final screen appears, press the button labeled C to close the installer. You should now have a folder named UTAU wherever you elected to install it to, and a program shortcut on your desktop. Inside your UTAU folder, you should have three subfolders labeled Plugins, Res, and Voice, some TXTs and DLLs, a resampler, a wave tool, and UTAU itself. Inside the voice folder, you should have a subfolder labeled Uta. That's Defoko, the default voice of UTAU. In her voice bank, there should be several wave and frequency files with hiragana names. If these symbols don't look correct, it means that your locale wasn't set properly. Completely uninstall UTAU, repeat the steps from earlier in this video, and reinstall it. Finally, open up UTAU. If your interface isn't in English, find Tūru, T, on the toolbar, then go to Option, O. In the Options window, click on the second sub-tab of the first page. Select the last checkbox, and choose EN from the drop-down menu. Click OK, close UTAU, and then reopen it. Now, everything should be in English, and we're ready to start using the software. This concludes this introductory video. I hope you found it helpful, and look forward to more tutorials coming soon. In the next video, I'll be going over how to download other voice banks and how to use them in the software. After that, we'll cover how to record and configure voice banks of your own. I would also like to make a few one-off tutorials in the future covering topics such as multi-pitch voice banks, reckless writing, advanced configuration techniques, and possibly some character design tips or more linguistic-y content. Let me know any suggestions you have down in the comments. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys next time. Select the last checks box.